Yeah, so continuing with the Maimer of Uvachodesh Hashviei, Maimer speaks about the month of Tishrei, Shoshana. And we asked a few questions yesterday. Maimer, as usual, start off with a few questions. Because the Uvachodesh Ve'echod L'chodesh Echod, Midrash says Echod Re'avom, is referring to Avom Avinu. Then it says, Ve'echod l'chodesh, Mikra Kodesh. Mikra Kodesh is referencing to Yaakov, because it says, Mikoi is Keilai Yaakov, or Eilai Yaakov, V'yisrael Mikroi, a pasuk in Yeshaya. The Mikra is referencing to Yaakov, and Yom Teruah Yelachem, referencing to Yitzchak. Yavin Isle. So the Keren, the horn of the isle, the horn of the ram is taken from the shofar that we blow on Rosh Hashanah is taken from the ram. So we need to understand the order of why is it first Avram, then excuse me, why is it Avram, then Yaakov, then Yitzchak. Vein bze gimel din pirush hakosuv echod avom. So Vayir speaks in general about this concept of each one. Why saying that echod, though it says echod avom, but what's the connection between why we're referencing avom to the concept of echod or Rosh Hashanah to? So the essential concept of Rosh Hashanah is the Avos, is the forefathers, the patriarchs. So, Ayin v'zeh, Ayin pirush hakosu, Echod ha'yavom, Shavom pal inyan achdus havai beilu. What did Avom do? He taught achdus, unity in the world. Meshakosu v'ikro shem havai b'shem, v'ikro shom b'shem havai kelo ilu. Al tikrei, v'ikro ela v'yakri. So Avraham Avinu taught the world about godliness, unity of Hashem. Avraham taught and publicized in the world, the entire world, Shakish Bochu Kel Oilom. What does it mean? Lei Kel Ho'olam Ela Shekel Oilom. He taught humanity, he taught the world that Hashem himself is Elikus. That's the difference between Kel Olam and Kel Ha Olam. Kel Olam means that there is a world, but Hashem is the master of the world. Kel Olam, meaning that the world itself is not separated from Elikus. The world itself is Elikus. Got the difference between Kel Ha'olam and Kel Olam. It's very important, you should know this. What did Avraham Avinu teach the world? If somebody asked you, what does Avraham Avinu teach the world? Chassidus tell us that Avraham Avinu taught that they don't say Kel Ha'olam, say Kel Olam without the hay. What's the difference between this and that? So it tells you Kel Ha'olam with the hay means that there is a world, and the world has a master. Who is the master of the world? Hashem. Okay? Right. Kel Olam means that the world itself is a likus. It's not that there's two entities and Hashem is...
Right.
It's one entity with Hashem.
The other one is like the manager in the office. The second
no,
one.
No, that's already going into why they later on they developed Avodah Zarah. We're not even going there. He's saying, if you would ask Avraham Avinu, what is your philosophy? What are you teaching the world? He's telling you, I'm teaching humanity that the world itself is godliness. The world is not separated from Hashem, and Hashem just runs it. That's not what he came to say. He came to say that the world and Hashem is one.
Okay.
The world itself is God in this. Is not the world itself is not separated from Hashem. That's what it means. Sha'olam atzmoi hu alikus. The Rebbe writes it in the Kutar Parshas Tovay, and it's also written in the memorial of the Rebbe Rashab in Tafri Shine Beis. V'zehu be'echod. We say Uvachodesh Hashviei be'echod l'chodesh, in the seventh month, on the first of the month, which the Torah tells us about Rosh Hashanah. Be'echod is Avram. Echod is referencing to Avram. What did Avram wanted to do? What was the inyan of Avram Avinu? What was the mission of Avram Avinu? To reveal, publicize unity of Hashem in the world. What does it mean, unity of Hashem in the world? That the world is not separated from godliness. Nischadish b'Rosh Hashanah b'Echad l'Chodesh, and this inyan was nischadish, was renewed, revealed in Rosh Hashanah. Chaydua shb'Rosh Hashanah yim b'Adam Rishon. Hashem created first man, which is the sixth day of creation. Omar Adam Rishon, what did he say on Friday when Adam Rishon was created? What was the first thing he said? It's the Ayom Yom that we say every Friday. You say Ayom Rishon b'Shabbos, Ayom Sheni b'Shabbos. Come to Friday, say Ayom Yom Shishi b'Shabbos. Which pasuk you say? Hashem Molach Gius Lovish. That's the pasuk in Tehillim that this pasuk was said by Adam Rishon already, first man. When it says in the Midrash, the entire creation came and started bowing to him. They saw that he is superior to them. And he told them, no, you're bowing the wrong person. I was also created. Hashem Moloch Gius Lovish. Omar Adon Rishon, Avay Moloch Gius Lovish. So Adon Rishon really crowned Hashem. Sheidia b'chol ha'briya kula asher Avay Moloch. He's the first one to tell them, hey, I'm not the king. Hashem Moloch. Hashem is the king. After Adam HaRishon announced and publicized the kingship of Hashem in the world, he added, Ve'omar bo nishtach v'nichro livroch l'vnei avai Hashem. Let's bow down to Hashem. So he himself nullified himself. He was nullified, himself was nullified to Hashem. He nullified himself to Hashem. V'chein u'b'rish Hashanah shebechol shana v'shanah shebeim ze nimshach inyan achdus avay ba'elo. So Rosh Hashanah, every year, there's a hamshacha, there's a revelation of this concept, achdus avay ba'elo, that Hashem and the world are one. Nullification of created being to godliness, like people, like the nation nullifies himself to a king. Zeh gam mikra kedush de Yaakov. It says be'echod l'chodesh, b'chodesh hashvi'i be'echod l'chodesh, mikra kedush yelochem. What's mikra kedush? So Mikra Kedesh is connected with Yaakov. Why is it connected with Yaakov? Shebechol Rosh Hashanah nimshach inyan v'chinas Yaakov. That every Rosh Hashanah there is an inyan, the drawdown that comes from above, is revealed in the world, and this concept is the level of Yaakov. What is it? The inyan Yaakov is Yibokah. If you play with the letters of Yaakov, you put the bet in front. You put the yud, and then base instead of ein, and then kuf, and then ein. So you play with the letters. You take the base and you put it instead of the ein. You put the ein at the end. Kuf remains where it is. So you just take the ein of Yaakov, you put it at the end, and the base you put closer to the Yud. So you now turn the word, instead of Yaakov, to what letter? What word? Iboka. Yeah. What does it mean, Iboka? Iboka means to break through. Livkoa means to chop down something, to split open something. Splitting it open. Iboka. The Ine Yaakov is Iboka Shaloch in this Abazaya. She Yaakov Omar Az Iboka Kashachar Yerecho. It's a pasuk in Ishaya. But it says that Yaakov is the one who said the statement. David HaMelech merely took it from Yaakov. Az Iboka Kashachar Yerecho. So the Zohar says. Meaning it's also saying that it'll be a the Shachar is the morning. Shachar Iboka, or the light of the morning will break through. The Mital Rebbe explains it in the Siddur, in the Amorim. Chassidic discourses are written in the Siddur. Bedrush Chag HaSukkah, a special Siddur that we spoke about many times. There's a Siddur with the Amorim. It's called Siddur im Doch.
You showed it to me.
Yeah, so Bedrush Chag HaSukkah, Shezo Ma Sha'akav Ba'ikeas HaTzimtzum. So it says, it's written in Kabbalah in many places, that before the creation of limited finite world, the godly infinite light field pervaded the entire reality or existence, and there was no room for, there was no possibility to create worlds. So in order for creation to take place, Hashem contracted and pushed aside, so to speak, the infinite light, and after this contraction there was a very fine, narrow, contracted light that is called Eir HaKav, the light of the Kav, of the line is a Kav that pervaded, that splitted open the contraction and penetrated through the contraction in order to create the worlds. And that's what Pasuk meant. Aziboka kashachar erecho is referencing to this original primordial light that took place. Chayvan shebikias atzimtzum, and this splitting open the contraction, meaning overcoming the concealment that was created through the tzimtzum and still revealing something. Eir HaKav. Tzad bechinas ha'eir shelamala matzimtzum. Where is it coming from? Obviously, it's enabled through a light that is higher than the tzimtzum. From the perspective of that light, the tzimtzum is not the concealment. This contraction is not a concealment. Lo chin yesh b'zemaylo gam ala eir d'b'chan savo. Therefore, there is even a superiority. This light, az iboka k'shocharecha, has even a greater superiority of the light that Avraham Avinu revealed in the world. Why? Ha'er anim shachal d'Avraham, the light that was drawn down through Avraham. Afshoyo b'ofin shel vayakri, although Avraham Avinu publicized and revealed godliness in the world, mikol mokim er zeh, this light, lechod Avraham, did not penetrate the world. Der oyer hot nit durchgenommen. Unit durchgenurden. See if I read it. Unit durchgedrungen. die Welt. So the world did not, the light did not capture the world, and the light did not penetrate the world. Bepnimius, in an inner way. Ella, so only thing what happened. The light radiated in the world in a general way, in a makif kind of way, in an encompassing way. Yaakov was able to do iboka, splitting open. What does it mean, split open? He opens you up, he gets inside you. That's what Yaakov brought to the world. So the light is penetrating the physical reality and creates a change in it. Because if I'm only affecting you externally, you can brush it off. It's not something that changes you. But he, if, like what Yaakov did, he changed, he made an internal change. What is the meaning? Remember, we learned in a different mimer that there is emes, it's fast emes, there is emes, and there is emes lamita. There's three levels in emes. Yaakov is the inyan of emes lamita, the ultimate truth. And the light that comes through Yaakov and has a kium, and has it's everlasting. That's why his attribute is attribute of emes. As far as emes tiko elad, something that is lasting forever. So this is teaching us something, that in order for any kind of inspiration to come and to change us, to affect us, it has to come to us innerly. We have to absorb it. If I hear it, and I'm even inspired by it, but I'm not really absorbing it, that's not going to create a change. Create a change, you have to absorb it. It has to penetrate you innerly. And that's what Yaakov was all about, iboka, to split open, to break through. You know, it's a famous, you know, the famous saying, like in English, they say many times, "Well, I couldn't get through him." What do you mean I couldn't get through him? He heard you. What do you mean?
Get through to him.
I couldn't get through to him.
Right, he wasn't listening.
Maybe he was even listening. Right. But you couldn't convince him.
The message didn't penetrate.
Right, the message didn't penetrate. That's the idea. You're not convincing enough.
Right.
Mikol mokem yesh milo biyakov v'chinas chesed l'avom. V'af shetite nemes Yaakov v'davka achev v'chinas chesed l'avom. Although tite nemes Yaakov comes after we said chesed l'avom. Avom came before Yaakov. So first the attribute of chesed is effective, does its thing, meaning Midas HaChesed is now in force, and only after comes the Midah of Emes. But it's not a proof that the attribute of Avram is higher than the attribute of Yaakov just because it's before. Because although it's earlier, although chesed comes first, nevertheless, there is superiority to Yaakov over the chesed of Avram. Shedavka Yaakov b'chinas emes, specifically Yaakov is the attribute of emes, that is, as we said before, it's connected with doing something that has an eternal effect. Only through Yaakov, the godly light is now Nimshach is drawn down to every single place. Bein Mokum, whether it's a spiritual place or whether it's a lowly place. Uvavish v'chol Mokum v'shove. And the light of Yaakov shines. The light that comes through Yaakov shines equally. Shezeo inyam v'chinas emes. This is the attribute of emes. She poeles that shines and radiates in the world equally. It's already mentioned in many places. In Zohar, Likutero, Shir Hashirim, that Yaakov is the middle beam that connects all sides. There's other beams that supports the building, but the middle beam is the main beam. Yaakov is the level of light that is above Tzimtzum, above contraction. Meaning it's light of Ein Sof that does not differentiate itself to Milo Mato, to higher and lower. Comes to this light, there's no such a thing as Chalkus divisions. That's why the drawdown of this light is equally in all places. And this is the meaning of Mikra Kodesh. We said Mikra Kodesh is referencing to Yaakov. Why? Mikra Kodesh, Pirush, Zimnin Mikodesh, the Kodesh Milo Begame. Kodesh is a word by itself, and it's not a word that is supported by another word. Meaning, Kodesh is a title, something that is holy. So Kodesh is the Shem Ha'etzem, is the Kedusha itself. Therefore, the title Kodesh represents a higher level in godliness, the Kedusha itself. It's something that is aloof, higher, loftier than Yomim, than the regular days of the week, the mundane days. This is referring to a level of the infinite light, the Ein Sof, the Blig Vul. That is above any kind of limitations, any kinds of concealments, any kind of contraction. Vinyonai, shel Yaakov, and this is the concept of Yaakov. Shekeru mamshir gam b'chinas says that Yaakov is capable of revealing, awakening this light, this revelation. Eir shel ma'ilo matzimtum, light that is above the contraction. Not only Yaakov is tapping to a light that goes through the Tzimtzum, rather he taps into a light that is above Tzimtzum. And this is the connection between Rosh Hashanah to Yaakov. V'zeu ha'shaychus l'Rosh Hashanah l'Yaakov v'chol Rosh Hashanah nimshach. Obviously, according to Chassidus, every Rosh Hashanah, there is a drawdown of godly revelation in the world. Sh're'edua she'v'chol Rosh Hashanah chozim v'dvorim v'kadmusim. It's known that every Rosh Hashanah, there is retrieval, so to speak. Everything goes back to its original source. Vim ken muvan sham shor shor shon im khas shor shor. It says in that choyzer umeir ha'er, the light comes back and shines. Choyzer umeir ha'er laki, shir bevir etchil. A light that is shown in creation in the beginning, at the time of its creation. Says the drawdown that takes place in Rosh Hashanah is mibchinas, from where is this flow coming from in Rosh Hashanah? Shirish Harishon, the original, the first root. Meaning, what is the first root? The will of Hashem to create the world. At the end of itself. Father, Pim of Vigas Akedesh, Tanya, Shemchol, Shashon, Nimshach, Ir Chodesh. I don't know if we got to it. We're learning Yigas Akedesh now. We are in a part where we're learning Yigas Akedesh. So in the daily Tanya, so it says this is in Siman Yudalad. Now we're in Epistle 17. I'm not sure if we passed it, but anyway, Shabbichol Shashanim Shachar Chodesh. Every Hashanah is a new light, but even a superior light. Shaloyam Meir Er Chodesh El Yisrael Meir Adan Mime Elam. It was not radiating Mime Elam from earlier times. Er Elyon Kaze, such lofty light. Umizem Muvan Shabbirish Hashanah Aze Nim Shachar Elyon Yisrael. Self understood that in Rosh Hashanah there is even a greater light. That did not even exist in the time of Bais Rishon. And in times when the moon was in its completion. As the Zohar speaks about the time of Shlomo HaMelech, that there was a certain Shlemus, completion in the world and in Am Yisrael in the time of Shlomo HaMelech. And that's why Shlomo is called Shlomo, Sholem. He brought Shlemus, completion. To a certain degree, they reached Shlemus. When you say Kaimus Yarba Shlomut, it's referring to the moon, when the moon is full.
There should be a circus this year.
Yaakov, Kol Rosh Hashanah B'chinas Mikra Kodesh. The entire Rosh Hashanah is Mikra Kodesh. Which means I'm shocha mebchinas kodesh mila begamish zonyon shel Yaakov. V'zo gam zichron tuo ze Yitzchak. So, what is mikra kodesh ze Yaakov? Every Rosh Hashanah is mikra kodesh. Every Rosh Hashanah there is a kriya, there is a calling. Ham shocha, a new revelation. From the word Kodesh, the Kedusha itself, and this is the Inyan of Yaakov that is connected, the concept of Yaakov is connected with Eir, with light that preceded any kinds of contractions. Eir Shalif Natsimtzum. We'll stop here. Continue, God willing, tomorrow.